old palaces and mosques unlike any you would have seen before. This is in Jaunpur, about 100 kilometers from Allahabad. The story of the city is as fascinating as the buildings you will find here. Founded in 1359 by the Sultan of Delhi, Firoz Shah Tughlaq, the city was named after his cousin, the infamous Muhammad bin Tughlaq, whose real name was actually Jauna Khan. But the rise of the city as a capital was thanks to a slave who was also a eunuch, who went on to establish the Sharqi dynasty, which ruled the region. At its prime, the Jaunpur Sultanate, as it was called, extended from Itawa in the west to Lakhnauti in the east, and from Vindhyachal in the south to Nepal in the north. The kingdom was a formidable military power, and under it, Jaunpur became a great center of Urdu and Sufi studies. It was also renowned for its communal harmony, best reflected in the architecture of the period, a unique amalgamation of Hindu and Islamic styles that cannot be found anywhere else in the country. The first of these gems is the Shahi Qila, also known as Kirar Kot, first constructed under the Delhi Sultanate, but considerably improved upon and expanded under the Sharqis. The fort houses Jaunpur's oldest mosque, next to which is a tall pillar commemorating the rule of Sultan Ibrahim Shah, under whom the dynasty reached its peak. Also in the fort is the Bhul Bhulaiya, built as a Turkish hammam with provision for both hot and cold water. It received its name from the maze-like path leading up to the hammam. The famous Atala Masjid is another gem first constructed by the Tughlaqs and improved upon by the Sharqis. Interestingly, Sharqi mosques do not have minarets, as can be seen in the Jhinjiri Masjid and the Lal Darwaza Masjid as well. Finally, you have the Jama or Badi Masjid, the largest mosque in Jaunpur. The graves of most of the Sharqi sultans and their nobles are close to the Jama Masjid. The tombs must have been architectural marvels before the sacking of the city by Sikandar Lodi after the fall of the Sharqi sultans. Jaunpur never regained its grandeur, but it was still beautiful, earning the title of Shiraz-e-Hind by Shah Jahan, who compared it to Shiraz, the capital of Iran. Today, few remember this once great city.